We do not need to rush. We should see this desert for ourselves.
Look, I know we can't trust prophecy, but I'm not sure we should just ignore what we saw either.
We are not ignoring it. We will discuss it back home. For now, I wish to search for the wounded animal you heard earlier.
You? Really?
Yes.
Well, okay then. Good. Yeah, lead the way.
We should be able to reach the Barrens up top, once we find a way past this hive matter.
I remember these things. Definitely Dark Elf territory.
Hail, fellow travelers!
Atreus heard a creature in pain in the desert.
Over a storm like this? Most impressive.
You know Alfheim pretty well, right? Do you have any idea what's out there?
No, sorry. The elves and I... Long story, but it's best when we keep out of each other's way. Hive matter is... stickier than I care for. Good luck on your search, though. Stuff some cloth in your ears to keep the sand out. Don't knock it till you've tried it.
Surprised to see you out here, Sindri. You must hate the sand.
Oh, it is the worst. But with Brock banned from Alfheim, it's up to me to keep you ship-shape and sharp.
So why is Brock banned from Alfheim?
Oh, that's, I don't know if... Well... Do you know what a juicy gnocchi is?
No.
Well, thanks to Brock, the elves sure do.
What is a juicy...
No.
This axe just keeps getting stronger.
What are these animals?
Gulon, native to Vanaheim. Not sure what they're doing here.
Someone trained them to pull a sled. Lucky for us.
Domesticated Gulon. Most unusual.
Any particular direction to find your wounded animal? Or are we just enjoying the weather?
I can't hear anything out here.
Perhaps we find a cave first to catch our bearings? Not getting up there with all this sand in your way. Tempting treasure chest! Damn the sand!
I don't think we're getting through that gate in this storm. What's that?
A diagram for a sword hilt.
Perhaps we should show it to one of the dwarves. They'll know what to do with it.
Thank you.
So you just refuse to pick a favorite poem? That's uncharacteristically indecisive of you.
I have a favorite poem already. One from my homeland.
Whatever this thing is, I think the animal's inside.
Whatever's inside is kicking up quite a bit of sand.
How do we reach it?
There's caves and tunnels aplenty out here. Let's find one and see where it takes us.
Thank you.
There's a cave entrance!
This cave extends underneath the desert. Is the creature within?
Yeah, sounds like it. We'll find it if we keep going. What is this place?
A refuge for the Dark Elves, by the looks of it. One of the few remaining now that they're barred from the temple.
Great.
Ugh!
Attack us.
Well, this is their home. And considering what happened the last time we were in Oz, can you really blame them?
Patience. A virtue or a threat?
Depends on the reader. The creature you heard, what does it say now?
It's not always like that. Some animals are just... I feel what they're feeling, you know? And whatever this thing is, it's in a lot of pain.
I see.
Why do you ask?
I am curious.
Really?
I am capable of curiosity.
Okay. Okay.
Enchanted rings or whatever.
Much has changed for both of us.
Well, yeah. I'm just trying to figure out why you'd help some random animal.
Is this not what you want?
No, it is. I'm just surprised it's what you want, too.
To kill a bunch of dark elves to get there.
I remember a young lad whom, until this very moment, would take on an army of Draugr to save a wounded animal.
But these aren't undead Draugr. They're elves. I just want to make sure we're not repeating the same mistakes, getting involved where we shouldn't.
Thank you.
I know that, but I'm usually the one who drags us around trying to rescue animals. Why do you care so much? Is there something you're not telling me?
No.
Okay.
It. What is it?
Great Gefjun's ghost! That's the largest bloody half-goof I've ever laid eyes on!
It's not just in pain. It's trying to sing.
It's the Song of the Sands. We don't normally sing like this underground.
Is that what's causing the storm?
Aye. Judging by all this hive matter weighing it down, it's been trapped here for dozens of winters.
Don't worry, Lynch. We'll get you out.
What is that name?
Well, the last good thing we saw was Diener, so...
Oh boy. While I appreciate the attempt at humor, that little brother is truly awful wordplay. Embarrassing, really.
Oh, well, can't all be winners. There's gotta be a way to clear those rocks. Get a better angle.
Like it can move now, but it still can't get out.
Much of the hive matter is gone. We can free it from the surface now.
Why did they trap it down here?
Halfgifers are known to burrow, so I'd hesitate to place full blame on our dark elf friends.
But it's trapped in their hive stuff.
Hive matter doesn't belong to the Dark Elves, any more than the light belongs to the Light Elves. It's just another of Alfheim's natural resources, one the Elves have used since the time of their ancestors. And while the Light Elves seem keen to banish the Hive over on their side, the Dark Elves make effective use of it out here in the Barrens.
So, by clearing out all of this heart, are we hurting Dark Elves?
You wish to leave the creature enslaved?
No.
Then let us free him.
This is the spot! We can cut the half Koopa loose here.
It flies? Of course it flies. It's a half Koopa.
Sounds much happier now. And hey, the storm's gone.
Aye. Perhaps we'll finally earn some goodwill from our Dark Elf friends after all.
Look, Father, thanks for bringing us out here, but you don't have to do this kind of stuff just to keep my mind off Ragnarok, you know?
This was not a distraction.
No? Then why are we really out here?
Have you ever considered... He just wants to spend time with you, lad, while he still can.
Really?
We do not know what lies ahead, but if Ragnarok approaches, I wish to enjoy the time we have left.
I don't know what to say. Thank you for bringing us out here. I'm glad we did this.
As am I.
There's something I'm not sure I quite understand. In the Ragnarok prophecy, Odin knows, all the realms get destroyed, including Asgard. In the version Groa kept secret, Asgard still falls. Wouldn't Odin have tried to prevent it either way? What difference did her lie really make?
Wait, let us look this way.
Looks like a lot of the sand is cleared up, but there's another storm out that way. You think that means...
Another half Koopa!
Remember to ask Tyr about his travels to the lands beyond the seas.
You wish to travel the world?
I don't know. Maybe. See new places. Find out more about myself. Mm-hmm.
bloody dropper.
On your right!
Reminds me of tales of a cruel empress, one too angry to die.
We will see.
Brother, I had a thought. What if we took a stealthy approach to our next battle?
No.
I've been considering your question about whether Groa's deception made a difference. I think of it this way. When it comes to subverting prophecy, knowledge is power. Without the full picture and context, the finer details can lead you to tragically incorrect interpretations. Back in my homeland, I was privy to the operations of a certain coven of Heathwitches who were keen on destabilizing the government. They picked an influential thane, an otherwise loyal man, and fed him a story of his own ascension to king.
Let this wait. Stay alert.
Brother, you ever think of cooking meat with those blades of yours?
No. They would foul the meat.
Oh, because of the magic on them?
The blood.
Ah, yes. Carry on then.
How can I help? This must be from Alfheim. Explains the, sand. And Atreus? Kratos? I'll heat up the forge.
Fits.
Want something in particular? Strike true. Take care of your arm.